Today we're going to be making money for 5 hours straight here on Hypixel Skyblock, and this has been cut down to less than 15 minutes. So if you guys could take a moment to drop a like and subscribe, that would mean a lot to me. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and get this started. And before we actually do anything, let's quickly check how much money we actually have in the bank. So we have 216 million coins. And we're gonna be obviously doing flips on a big scale, small scale, a little bit of everything. So let's go ahead and begin searching for items that we could flip for profits. And I think I'm gonna be focusing a lot on the auction house, and I'm gonna be trying to see if we can craft some items that are for profit, and I'm gonna show you guys how I'm actually finding it. So as you guys can see, I right now put random and I put it to legendary tier, and also you can do mythic tier. These are typically high ticket items that you can flip for profit. So right now we have like some pets that can be quite a bit of profit. As you guys can see, we craft them. Obviously pets are a bit of a gamble because we might not get the right tier. Maybe some armor pieces could be profit right now, so I'm gonna start doing a little bit of a search here. You know what, I'm gonna quickly go ahead and pause this timer and install the scrollable tools, because it's just impossible to look at the auction house at this point. Anyways, we found our potential first flip, except that right now the Revenant Viscera prices are pretty high up there, and as you guys can see, we spent about 8 million coins on this materials, and what we're gonna be crafting is a Reaper mask, which we can potentially sell for 8.5 million. So that's 400,000 profit. Not the best, but seems to be kind of decent. And as you guys can see, actually raw cost, it says a lot lower, but I think it's because the revived hearts are currently in hot demand and there's barely any on the market for a low price. As you guys can see, there's literally only 2 revived hearts here. Now, actually, one thing that I could potentially try out is that I will buy both of them and I will try to sell them for 3 million. But we can try it out. Why not? So let's do this little risk here. Let's buy all of them and then boom. And now there shouldn't be any revived hearts on this marketplace here, because we bought all of them. And let's see if these are gonna sell. This is almost 1 million profit then. Would be nice if we can manage to do that, but let's see here. All right, so right now it looks like the Revenant Viscera is gonna take a while, so this is not the best flip, but I found the next flip, which is gonna be requiring lily pads. That's right, we're gonna be flipping some Rod of the Legends, I think. I think this is probably right now the best one to flip. Let's actually do buy instantly, 512. Boom, that's 29,000. And then we're gonna go ahead and buy enchanted lily pad, buy instantly. I think we're gonna need 136, so there we go. So that's 1.2 million. Now we're gonna turn this into challenging rod, kabam. Now we're gonna turn this into rod of the champions, and boom, rod of the legend. So we spent 1.2 million on it, and as you guys can see, we can potentially sell this for 1.7 million, so that's 500,000 profit. Anyways, while we're here at the bazaar, we're gonna go ahead and actually make an order for null spheres, and we're gonna be buying 12,800 of them. And then we're also gonna be making an order for 3,200 enchanted obsidian. Anyways, we're gonna be taking these materials and we're gonna be making nullavoids, but I wanted to see how much money can we make potentially flipping the null spheres, because I know flipping null spheres typically works pretty well. And it turns out we can make almost 1 million profit from investing about 22 million or so. And this is pretty insane. So I'm thinking to redo that in a bit, but definitely 1 million profit on such an easy bazaar flip, why not? Okay, so we're about to reach the 1 hour mark now. And as you guys can see, the null voids are being crafted right now. And it does look like this might actually be selling at these higher prices. I'm gonna relist it, but that's almost 1 million profit right there, which is obviously good as well. And I think this crafting here is gonna bring us more than 1 million profit. And here we go, the last ones. Let's go ahead and put them for sale and let's see how much money we're gonna be making off this. We're gonna sell them at 354,000 each. And on an average, it costed us to make one about this much. So this is pretty decent profit right here. Anyways, I think I want to see if these are going to be fulfilling fast. If they are, I'm going to go ahead and actually make another order for them. We're going to go ahead and claim this in the meantime. And I think we're going to relist this order. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I'm going to relist it for a while here. And it does look like the prices have been dropping a bit for null spheres, which is not good. And I'm not sure if I'm going to sell any more of the Rod of Legends, because it's taken, I guess, up to an hour to sell, which is not good. Anyways, now we're gonna be doing some farming and we're gonna go ahead and use the elephant pet for this. Alright, so while we're doing the farming, of course, we're doing the bazaar flips and it's going pretty well. As you guys can see, we have over 22 million to claim here. And this is from the null spheres that made us a ton of profit. I mean, 1 million profit, just like that. I'm thinking to do that again, but also I'm finding some other flips and one of them is buying enchanted string and then revenant flesh, and this total costs us like 39,000. Now what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna turn this into revenant viscera and we're gonna be able to sell this for 44,000. So that is pretty solid profit right there. So I'm thinking to do these as well. And yeah, it does look like the null sphere is still pretty good profit. You know what? I'm actually gonna go ahead and flip this here. That's about 300,000 right there. Not bad. All right, I just finished crafting the next rod of the legends and look at this. They're pretty expensive right now. So we can sell this potentially for 2 million. So let's hope that it sells. And of course, we're not gonna flood the market right now. So we're gonna take it nice and easy. But this should be then like 700,000 profit or so, which is pretty solid. So let's do that and let's keep on farming. Okay, so I went AFK for a little bit. I did some editing and I came back. And well, firstly, why I'm wearing this storm set is because I thought maybe I'm gonna grind out some sludges. Did that. It's actually pretty good money still, and turns out that they put the sludge juice into bazaar instead of the auction house. But anyways, turns out, yeah, it's good money. And secondly, we have been crafting a ton of nullavoids while I have been AFK here. I time to time open up the bazaar, claim the orders, and make new nullavoids because the amount of profit we can make on this is freaking crazy. So let's go ahead and sell these here. And it does look like they have dropped in prices quite a bit. As you guys can see, it's now 343,000. And also the crafting costs have changed a bit. So I'm gonna put on the screen right now the profit of these right here. This was pretty insane. And also it does look like we have some minions filling up. Now I'm not gonna be collecting the minions in this video because, well, minions have been working here much longer than the 5 hours total we're doing, so yeah. Anyways, while we're gonna be waiting for the orders to be fulfilling, we're gonna go ahead and begin farming yet again. And yeah, of course, during this time we're gonna do more bazaar flips to maximize our profits, but it does look like these nullavoids are not selling as fast as I want them to, and it does look like these didn't actually sell at this price point, so I think I'm gonna relist these as well. Not good. It means our profits are getting a tiny bit smaller, but it is what it is, you know? Anyways, yeah, looks like the null sphere flipping is probably one of the best ways to go. Because flipping is just so freaking easy. So let's go ahead, right click, flip order 1802. We're gonna put the lowest price available. And then boom. Hold on, hold on. Yo. What? Oh my god, did I just mess? Oh my god. Wait, what? What? Why does it say minus 10 million? Hold on, what? Oh! Oh my god, I got so scared because I claimed half of these orders already. I'm like, hold on, something doesn't add up. oh my god, I got so freaking scared for a second. I'm like, yo, this has gone wrong real quick. And if you guys are wondering how the timer is looking right now, well, it's been about 3 hours since we started this. Oh man, I have to do this pickup stash thing again. This is, dude, I'm spending most of the time doing this. I wanted to start some farming, but it is what it is. Anyways, yeah, I think I'm doing more flips to be honest, because these flips are big money, like straight up big money. So let's do that. Okay, so we actually have a lot of orders to claim. We're gonna be making this revenant viscera in a minute. And the null sphere has sold, so that means we're gonna be flipping it again. Anyways, flip order and 1802. Let's see how much we're gonna be making off that. And that's 620,000 profit right there. And it does look like from the previous flip, most of the null sphere has already sold, which is obviously good news for us. Anyways, as you guys can see, the nullavoids have been selling as well pretty well, but there's still some nullavoids that need to be sold, so. And there we go, we managed to get the gold, which is obviously nice, which means we're gonna be moving on to the next flips finally. Okay, so here we are, we're getting the revenant viscera done, and as you guys can see, we do have quite a bit of it. Anyways, let's sell this and it should be pretty good profit. So I'm gonna put it on the screen right now, bam. And if it sells fast, we're gonna continue doing more, of course. But in the meantime, I guess I need to find a new item to craft, to be honest. And there were a few items that I found, but the margins were not that great. Uh-oh, not good news. The Nullavoid prices are dropping. Not good. Anyways, we relisted it. But yeah, I think I need to like keep a closer eye on it. And if it's not selling, I'm just gonna relist it every second minute or something crazy. So we're just gonna keep a closer eye on it. And yeah, but definitely I need to start speeding up because it's been 3 hours and 30 minutes already. Okay, so we're gonna continue making Revenant Viscera because it sells super quickly. And I mean, the profits are pretty good on this. Now, as you guys can see, the Nullavoids just keep on dropping down in prices. So I'm not exactly sure what caused it to go so high up there in the first place. But still, we're in profits, which is okay. And then also, I noticed that the Null Spheres are no longer such a good item to flip here. So let's quickly relist this. And that's 112,000 profit. I mean, it was a small order, but still, it looks like Null Sphere profits are not that large anymore. Okay, so now it's been 4 hours and 30 minutes or so, and as you guys can see, some of the orders are slowly fulfilling, which is obviously good to see. And I'm thinking to maybe relist some of them because obviously I want to make sure that it sells before the 5 hours comes to an end, so you guys can see how much money we actually ended up making. So let me start relisting some of these items. And we did make about 2.4 million of farming, which is pretty good as well. So we have about 5 minutes left to go, and yes, that's right, bazaar orders are kind of not fulfilling as fast as I want them to. And I'm literally thinking that maybe for the content, we're just gonna do quick sells so we can have an understanding how much we actually ended up making. So let's just start doing quick sell. It's gonna mean some losses, boys, but it is what it is. It is what it is. Sell inventory. And I think we have few items still on the auction house that didn't sell, like Rod of the Legends. I did lower the price, but it still hasn't sold. So I'm thinking maybe to either relist it so it sells instantly or just plus it on to the how much money we actually made. So we're sticking to this 5 hour schedule here. So let's quick sell, boom, boom, boom. And yeah, doesn't look like we made actually that much money. Wait a minute, did this quick sell mess me up like really bad? Or how? Oh no, wait a minute. Oh my god, yo, we are at 220 million only, and then plus this, so let's say we're at 224 million, but, oh wait, we have some items that are on the floor, but still though, oh damn, okay. So let's say, yeah, okay, plus 1.7. So that means in this 5 hours, we made 9 million coins. I mean, it's obviously not bad, but I thought we're gonna be making way more than that. Now, one of the things that I wanted to actually be flipping for profit, which I thought about, was Axe of the Shredded. And this was my initial idea for this video, that I'm gonna be flipping a bunch of the Axe of the Shredded. But the raw material costs were really high up there. I mean, right now it looks like it's 4 million profit each craft. But in the beginning, when I started this, that was not good profit. There were a few other high ticket items that I wanted to flip. Hence why I showed that I have 200 million, but I didn't even use like half of it during this process. So this is a takeaway. But I guess in the next episode of money making, I'm gonna be taking the full money and I'm gonna be focusing only on high ticket items to see if we can make stonks. And yeah, it looks like if we flip 2 times Axe of the Shredder, we're about to make about the same money that we made in... okay, pain, 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 pain. Anyways, I hope you guys have enjoyed the 5 hours of money making cut down to 15 seconds. So if you guys could take a moment to drop a like and subscribe, that would mean a lot to me. And let me know if you guys think this result is good or not. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace out.